request, and actually I put a few nice words at the beginning.
Did he accept?
He didn't reply even, yes.
So if you're listening, Prince George, I know that you like talking to plants and you like nature.
And we admire you.
Yes, we admire you, and we would really hope that you could sponsor this.
Or you could tell the world why you do not want to chair it.
That is a possibility. Yes. So if you have a good reason for not doing it, do that. Yes. But I'm sure he would, I mean, this, you know,
And also, please help make Stephen Hawking become a knight very soon. That's a personal request from me.
I understand you and we would sleep better if the LHC was not turned on as it is, yeah?
No, I cannot live with the idea that they will do it.
Yes.
I cannot think being able to live beyond that day. I do not want to commit suicide, of course, but I know it is impossible. It is not possible that the world is so stupid.
Yeah.
I
think in a way, okay, we may be optimists. I don't know. Maybe we're realists. I hope we're realists.
No. I know.
We hope for this.
If any child on the planet sees this interview, the child will know. No, my parents will not allow this to happen.
Yeah, and any parent should look at the child and understand this. If they like children and if they want a future for them, at least.
Yeah. And hopefully I'm wrong.
But in your personal opinion, right now, what would be the most efficient way to do this? Another lawsuit at some other court? Media?
Good question. No,
a political instrument, like, for example, we know that the Swiss Popular Initiative, you know, like, if the Swiss, you can launch an initiative, you need three people, you need to depose the initiative, get some time to get signatures, and you can actually
it's admirable.
Make the Swiss vote.
Yes.
Takes a lot of time. That's the problem there.
It ought to have started 2 years ago. Then it might have worked.
Yes, exactly. So that, but what would you personally think is the most effective way of getting this safety conference done?
It's very easy. If this discussion is being aired on the internet, and if the whole world does not respond, then the children of the planet would have a reason to ask why.
That is very nice. Yes, I agree. And if that doesn't happen, we will start to ask children on the street why.
Exactly.
And go to schools and ask them if they think that's okay.
Yeah.
And we will just continue. I mean, I know you will continue. I know others will continue. NOPA Publishing will continue. We will just continue.
Yeah. And we can also...
In the name of children.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Maybe that's a very good point to close on, but maybe you have even more very hard-to-answer questions.
We could close now, but actually I got two or three quite interesting questions.
Yes,
that
I'm sure.
Like
yes, I'm very curious.
And I'm very curious. That's why I'm asking so many questions. So, assuming some, and I think this is a good question, assuming some of the CERN scientists or other scientists participating at the LHC experiment are listening to this interview here, what would you tell them?
I would say, I'm glad to be among friends, and I'm completely on their side. With everything they think, I also underwrite it. And I'm sure they would not object to having let open why my warnings are false. And maybe if they tell the world, they don't object that the facts are put on the table, because they are my friends.
I have a little question, which is a bit special, but basically, I'm half Spanish, half Swiss, so I read a lot of Spanish media too, and since years they write quite often on the CERN, not very critical, but quite often, and they always call the CERN La Máquina de Dios, the God machine, the God's machine, whatever. Now, it just count two and two together in my brain, and I see this, especially if you look at these detectors, the CMS detector or the Atlas detector, they really look like cathedrals.
Yeah.
Is there religious or, kind of element to this?
By all means. I mean, science is the modern religion already. Although science doesn't talk about the essence of religion, which is where does the now come from,
yeah,
and where do colors come from. Mm-hmm. There is a beautiful red color on this sign. And no one knows where redness comes from. And science is kind of lying to everyone on the planet by not admitting that there's no scientific reason whatsoever why redness should exist. On the contrary, you can prove redness does not exist anywhere in the universe. But we have it. So it's a present from heaven given to us.
On these words...
Like the world itself, yes.
On these words, Professor Roessler, I think that's very nice final words. I would like to thank you for this interview. And I think we both hope, with possibly many of our listeners, that this safety conference will happen very, very soon.
I'm very grateful that such a notepad exists at you, as you just produced. Thank you very much.
Thank you.